Howdy, folks. Ever since I was a kid, I've always lived by the speed square. When I was building, you know, even small wooden sailboats when I was a teenager, this was, you know, this was the tool. In fact, this thing has been with me forever. But on the table saw, I always use this to check the blade and stuff. And we've got these new fancy digital ones. They were sent in this week, and I thought, you know what, we got to check all these out. We've got two different models, so that ought to be interesting. And we're going to put them up against the speed square and just see, you know, who's the wiener. Let's find out. Okay, we're back. And the first one was this gem red. And it's really basic, real simple. It's magnetic. It's around $20, I think. So it only has a magnet on, yeah, just the one side as is magnetized. And it just really simple, on off. So we'll turn it on. It says error. That's a good start. Yep. And then you can put on your table saw here, it's magnetic to the base, and hit the zero. And hopefully, I don't know, can you guys see that? That's zeroed out. Okay, try again, zero. I'm gonna put this up on the side of my, yeah, there we go. Just like that off the table saw. It says 45.1, so that's pretty close, but that's not 45 degrees exactly. And I don't know, is my speed square wrong? All these years I've had the speed square? I don't know. So the next thing I'm gonna do is let's put it up against this side. And it says it's 89.9. So let me go back to zero here, just see. Wow, it's trying to go off a little bit scale wise. So again, we'll try that. Nope, 89.9. So all these years of building and construction, apparently my speed square is no good. Now, should I believe this thing? I don't know. I'm not really liking it. As it moves around, the numbers jump all over the place. It's very sensitive, and so I'm not real fussy on that. The whole idea of this thing was, of course, was to zero your, you know, get a zero reading, on the blade, so the blade is exactly 90 degrees to the table. So let's take a look at the other unit, I guess. This other unit costs a little tiny bit more. It looks like we're getting a little rust buildup over here already. Don't like it. Yeah. All right. This one here is a little fancier. Yeah, it's got mode, hold, zero, and also, of course, on and off. So we'll start it up. And it looks like it says error, too. Maybe that's the way they're all supposed to start, is with error. Error. Yeah, I don't know. And the base for magnet is, okay, not there, not there, and boom. Okay, now we're magnetized. So I'm going to hit the zero, so we can zero this out. There we go, it's zero. Now I'm going to put this up on the speed square, and it says 44.40. So apparently, again, it says my speed square isn't any good. Oh boy, I'm gonna have to throw this away today, I guess. Jeez, anybody, you know, 44.45. It says it's wrong. Oh boy. Okay, let's go back to zero. Just see if we have zero still. Well, it still has zero, so that's, oops, excuse me. Sorry about that, guys. That's something. So let's try the 90 and just see. That does not even make sense to me, but I'm sure somebody understands it. It's just not, I don't understand. I'm old school. This is the way I live. You know? I live by my speed square, not by these crazy digital toys. I think my phone probably has a better application than this thing. Let's try that. Just see. 89.9. So from this flat surface that I zeroed at, there's a zero. If I roll it over, now it should be, not, and it is. Now I'm showing 90. So, and if I push against this, it says 89. It says my speed square is wrong. Wow, I didn't think I was going to be this frustrated today with these things. I really was thinking I was going to be impressed. Yeah. So when I check my blade with my speed square, apparently to my saw table, I'm doing a pretty good job of it. With these, I'll be honest, I don't think I can even trust these things. This is crazy. Right now, let's see, we're back to 0.5 again or something on the surface. Let's see if we can get a good, no, we're still off again. This one's still jumping a little bit too, but right now, okay, we're both at zero again. So I don't even know what to do at this point. This is not what I expected to see today at all. Let's try the 45 again. Just see if we can get a 45 on here. No, not really. Well, not an exact 45. It should, like, 45.0 would be wonderful, but that's not what I'm getting. 45.01. Well, 0.1. That's not too bad, but, you know, if I'm going to cut with a saw, I really like to see some accuracy. And I'm not getting that. Let's try this one here, same thing. And this one here is showing 45.3. Wow. I'm going to ask for comments, guys, and see what you say, but I'm going to tell you right now, I know my speed square is, you know, it's a nice tool and it works great and it seems to be very accurate. These things here, I don't feel like we can even trust these things. Let's go back to the bench and discuss. Wow. So, I called a lifeline. I called a friend, but I didn't get any good answers for this. Ideally, when you have one of these, you can put it on your blade on your table saw as you turn your blade over to an angle or something. You know, you can read it and, you know, supposedly set it accurately. And you can also test it, especially to make sure if you have a proper 45, which I always check with my speed square, which according to this thing is the speed square is off, you know. So I got out my other speed square, the other one that's been with me forever, and I thought, well, just for fun, we'll try that one too. And I even referenced the table I've got here and then did my angle. And it's the same, it's like it shut off, battery saving too. It'll shut itself off, isn't that great? You know, yeah. So yeah, we'll go on the table here and we'll get her zeroed. Oops, okay, zero. And I'm just gonna go straight on the speed square and just gonna see what this says. And this says 46.9, 46.8. Okay. So guys, I don't know what to tell you. I'm lost. I can't get these things to give me 45 degrees exactly with one of these speed squares. I'm really not sure. I don't know what to make of all that. Maybe gravity has changed. Nah. So I even also tried this where you would stick it to the blade, and I did the blade first this way and then put it on my speed squares and ran it, and I still wasn't, you know, where I would like to see the, you know, I'd like to see exactly 45 degrees. So yeah, don't know. Really got an answer for this. Very disappointed, I guess, today. Anyway, let's get off of this. See, this is a disaster, and let's go to, we have a draw. We have, actually we have two draws today, and no booby prize. Wow, that happened. Yeah. Bam! Okay, my favorite part. We're giving away the metal blade first to lucky winner. Yep. And we're stirring up some tickets. Didn't have a lot of entrance for it, so let's see who we got here. Okay, Mr. I guess we'll call him Mr. Kelly, and he lives in Glendale, Arizona. That's a big ticket there, Kelly. Tell you what, some people write in and they do like a large font like that, and we reduce the font so it fits the size of our software usually. This one here didn't get done for some reason, but that's okay. Kelly in Glendale, Arizona. You can cut some metal, and I think you're gonna be impressed. They don't throw a lot of spark, and they seem to cut cooler than the grinder type blades and stuff, so they're pretty impressive. Also, I've talked to Graf. They will not make the spacer, and I'm not going to include one from me because I can only make a 3D printed one, I think. Unless you want one, maybe I should throw the 3D printed spacer in here with us if you need it. My grinder didn't fit it. Most grinders will not, apparently, and I talked to Graf about that. They said they're not going to make the spacers. They were looking for specific models of grinders that this would not work with for the guard. And so we get into a little discussion. But Graf has offered to send more stuff over for review in the future, so that's cool, you know. And thank you everyone for entering. If you did put your name in for the metal thing, that was great. Now, we're gonna get rid of all these tickets, and I'll be right back, and we'll do the wood. Bang, okay, for the wood blade, which is the one that really scared everybody. That sucker, you don't even feel it going through that wood. It just sort of, you know, slices. We got a lot more tickets, oddly enough, a lot more entries for the wood blade. Even including a lot of Canadians. They're brave, you know. They'll take the wood blade on and give it a shot, you know. There's quite a few in there from Canada, so. But let's see who's got a wood blade coming to them. Okay, we've got a ticket, just a nice little ticket right here, and oh my God, yes, good. I'm sort of glad. This guy has been putting his name in since, I think since the first day we started putting something on the show to give away. So at least, Chris, you know who you are in Mendoza, California. Good old Chris, oh my God. Chris, you're finally gonna get something from me. I'm gonna send you this wood blade. I want you to be very careful with it. And let me know if you need that spacer, or I'll make you one. Well, poor old Chris has been around forever. He's always a good guy, and he's, whoops. And I just broke your blade. No, I'm just kidding. He's always put his name in for whatever we've got going on, and I always appreciate that. In fact, I appreciate everybody. Put your name in, even if you've won stuff, put your name in again anyways, don't care. We just, you know, want just the viewers to have a chance to get whatever it is we're doing reviews on in general. And this stuff here was, Graf was nice enough to send me an extra set so I could send brand new over to the viewer. So that's great. Chris, I'm happy for you, man. you finally got something. Mr. Chris, alrighty, okay, now. We've got another draw coming up for this Thursday, and I guess you sort of already know what it's going to be. I'm not too fussy on this because I'm not overly impressed with the product. So if you get a chance and you have one that you do like and that you really like on your table saw, please let me know, and I'll, you know, send me a name or a link or something to it in the comment below, where I can't give me a link. I think YouTube will block that or something, but if you send me at least a name or a product name or something so I can look it up, and bring it in here so we can do a review on it, because that's what we're giving away. Next week we're gonna draw, and we're gonna have two names pulled from the bucket, and somebody's gonna get this one and somebody else is gonna get this one, and they're out of here. Now, I will provide links in the description below, affiliate links for help the channel, whatever, for these two products, but I'll be honest, I don't know, fellas, I don't know. It depends on the accuracy, I guess, and even then, today's testing was a disaster. I really did not expect to see the results that I got. Apparently, I should throw all my speed squares away because, you know, they're all inaccurate. I have no explanation on that, but here they are. Digital angle gauges, magnetic bases. I've got the boxes right here for them, so let's see. Next week, to enter the draw, put your name in. Email it to CTrewards@gmx.com. Yes, and then over here, let's see, subject. How are we gonna do the subject on these ones? Yeah, in the subject line of your email, I guess we'll just run angle. I'll put angle right there. Then in the body of your email, just your name and your address only, that's it. And next week on Thursday, we will draw two names, for one for each of these. One entry per household, like always. And thanks again, guys, for entering this past week. And we've got the Graf blades going out. And next week, we'll do these. Got some, got a big, heavy machine here. Almost took two guys to get it off the truck. And surprisingly, it's gonna be an interesting machine. I was gonna do it today, but it was like, we're gonna need a whole show, like a Monday show thing, where we just go over this whole thing to review it. So it was like, okay, set that aside. And I thought, well, these were sent in, and we'll check these out and test them. And because they were kind of a disaster, like I said, I'll give you the link in the description, but I'm not gonna recommend these products at this point in time. I'm still a little baffled over the readings that I got off my own table today. And I guess it's nice to have one, you know, if it's accurate. And it would be nice, especially when you're doing the 45 cut on the table saw, but I always use the speed square to check. So, and apparently, I don't know. Anyways, thank you for watching Coffee and Tools, and let's please like, share, subscribe, and ring the notice bell for when we have the next draw. Next Thursday? That. Okay, I'm out of here, and over and out.